Hello and welcome to the fourth video of our series, Even More Problems That Contain Percentages. We've been using this formula, percent over 100 equals is over of. Now, what do you do if you cannot determine the value to plug into the formula? Thus, this is the objective of this final video. We're going to break down the formula and we're going to go over four word problems where the values to plug into the formula may not be as obvious. Again, here's our formula. And this formula is just a simple equation. And what we've learned from equations, they must always balance. So if you know one part of the equation, you can solve for the unknown by just simply making sure the equation stays balanced. Let's break this formula into pieces. Let's begin with the percent over 100 part. To break this down, you look at this. This is pretty much just a percentage in fraction form. Thus, we're going to take an example like 30%. We're going to write this as a fraction. We have 30% equals 30 over 100, which fits into our formula, percent over 100. Now let's break apart the other part of the formula. We have the is over of. Now this part is, again, it's a simple fraction. The of part is also known as the denominator. It's also known as the initial amount, the whole amount, or the total. That's what we're going to put in this part. Now the is part is known as the numerator or parts of the whole. Thus, if we have is over of, it can also mean part of the whole and divided by the whole. Let's look at an example to give you a better understanding. We're going to start with the is over of because the percent over 100 is very easy to understand. If you had 10 apples and ate 3, let's write a fraction for the amount eaten. So you have the is over of, which we understand as being the numerator and the denominator, are the part of the whole and the whole. So the 10 apples are the whole part. You plug that in. And the part of the whole are the 3 that were left behind. I'm sorry, the 3 that you ate. So here's our completed solution, 3 apples over 10. Let's look at another example. 150 question test, the student got 70% correct. How many did the student get correct? So we have 150 question test, 70% were correct. We plug in our formula. We're going to begin with of. As we said before, this is the initial amount or the whole amount. The test was 150 questions, so we're going to plug that in there. We're going to move on to the percent. Very simply, the percent is the 70%. You're just going to plug that in right there. And now we have the is. Now this is the part of the whole. This is the part that we don't know right now. So we're going to plug in X there. And to solve it from this point, you can use video 1 to show you how to do that. Let's look at another example. Ann bought a 8-slice pizza, yet only 2 slices are left. What percent of the pizza is left? So, again, we begin with our formula. And we're going to start with the bottom part of, which again is the initial amount or the whole amount. And we began with 8 slices, so we're going to plug that in there. We're going to continue on with the is, which of course, as we said before, is part of the whole. So what is part of the whole? The 2 slices. So the last part we have to figure out is the percent. And At this point, we don't know the percent. So we're going to put an X there for the unknown. And if you want to solve this problem further, you can go look at video 2 and see how to solve this. Let's continue. Now with this word problem, we have a player that gets on base 48% of the time when at bat. That's 240 times on base. What is his total times at bat? So we want to know how many times he's at bat. So we're going to begin again with our formula. And we're going to plug in the percent because that's the easiest part. So we understand that he was on base 48% of the time. So we're going to plug that in. We're going to move over to the is. Now, where's the is value? We understand that's part of the whole, and part of the whole is 240. So that's the 240 we plug in there. Now, what value do we plug in for of? Of is the initial amount, the whole, it's the total. And that's unknown at this point. So we're going to plug in X there. So now that we have plugged in all the values we know for our formula, you can use video 3 to solve. All right, that's the end of our video. I've covered our objective, showing you how to break down the formula when the components to plug into the formula are not as obvious, and giving you 4 examples of word problems and how to solve them. Have a nice one, and thanks.